Records on the victims of Nazi atrocities were given to the International Red Cross in 1989. For the American Red Cross, it represented a new opportunity on a historic path, restoring family links. For the volunteers who would take up the new tracing challenge, many of them survivors themselves, the work of the Holocaust and War Victims Tracing Service was personal.
This program has done a lot for me, and it's not what I've done for it. It's really what it's done for me. I can't begin to explain it.
The tracing work is laborious, painstakingly accomplished through individual effort and the resources of Red Cross societies around the globe, as well as 700 chapters in the United States. A case ends by documenting either the hard facts of death or the joyous relief of survival and potential reunion.
Two ladies were sitting next to each other. And after beginning to talk, they realized that they were sisters. Each one had thought that the other one was long dead. And I don't have to tell you what happened. They started to scream. It was incredible. And right there, I felt that if it is possible for me to help in reuniting people, that's what I would like to do.
44 years, a brother and sister were apart, not knowing how to find each other. They were separated during the Holocaust. Well, tonight, they have found each other and the worker who brought them back.
Two Maryland women are about to see their brother for the first time in more than 50 years. The three were separated during the Holocaust.
Family separated in Germany after World War II is together this morning thanks to the help of the Red Cross.
For thousands of Holocaust survivors and their families, this Red Cross tracing service has answered anguished questions and provided a sense of closure.
I didn't think it was possible that I are alive after 50 years. I just didn't believe it.
Proof of forced labor or internment helped other survivors seek justice through reparations. But more than 1,600 reunions have captured the world's imagination.
Can you in any way describe that moment?
It's exploded. Atomic bomb exploded. Our brother is here, his wife is here, and we are happy.
You go to your local Red Cross chapter. You tell them you want to search for someone.
From its beginning in a local community, each request is thoroughly researched at the National Clearinghouse.
We write letters. We make calls to any Red Cross, any place in the world where there might be some information that we would like to have.
Hundreds of thousands of Nazi records in Erlsen, Germany. Archives scattered throughout the world. Scraps of information that defied deciphering. The tracing process was eventually transformed by technology.
Of course, it was all by hand. There was no computerized stuff. And so we had to learn how to use the computer, and we have it linked. We are doing a good job. We are still finding people.
1st of November, 94 was my happiest.
As in most good works, we don't necessarily get to see the results, but sometimes we're lucky, and our hard work is rewarded in person.
And the boardroom doors opened, and in walked the inquirer, his two daughters, his wife, a son-in-law, a grandson, this friend, and the sister and son. And everybody cried.